We're talking about how to use WordPress plugins for local SEO here on The Journey.
And WordPress is incredibly SEO friendly. The good news is that you don't have to do all of the heavy lifting for your SEO on your site. Plugins, which can be installed pretty easily, take it from me if I'm saying it's easy, and it expands the scope of your WordPress software to enhance its SEO.
But with a WordPress plugin repository of more than 54,000 free and open source plugins to choose from, which are the best choices? But before we give you that list, let's talk about what the local SEO ranking factors actually are.
That's right, Neely. There are some local SEO ranking factors, and there are so many moving parts when it comes to understanding and optimizing your SEO. So before you start installing any plugins, here are some of the basic factors to keep in mind, starting with Google My Business listing. This should be your very first step in establishing your online presence and your community. Also, don't just claim it and forget it. There's some more work that you can do there to help out your SEO. Update it frequently, add new photos, add videos to further capture people's attention.
And if you're like me, you're checking out the reviews of a place before you actually go there. The more good reviews you gather, the more your chances increase of having Google boost your website's ranking. That also goes for your business's response to those reviews. So don't let them go unanswered for too long, even the negative ones.
Another local SEO ranking factor is on-page copy, including local-centric content that is relevant to your clients and your community is a solid way to build on that local SEO. Now, this content should include key local phrases and location-based terms to make it easier for SERPs to determine where you are. And that way, you can get in front of users looking for, I don't know, what did I search recently? Oh, piano lessons. Piano lessons near me.
Exactly. And then the last ranking factor we have are backlinks. This is where another website will link to yours within their content. It's almost like a mini endorsement or a tiny upvote on your social post. Try to get listed in your local community directories and event pages. Guest blogging, sharing your website with local shopping guides, or news outlets are all great ways to do this. Do your best to get a few targeted local sites and not just any irrelevant website.
Yeah, and I even noticed, I was thinking about backlinks the other day. I was reading the GoDaddy blog, and I was reading this great blog about SEO, and then I went to see who wrote the blog. Went, clicked on this guy's link. It took me to his website. He's also in marketing. I was like, wow, this is great for him, right? Like, he has a backlink from the GoDaddy blog over to his website. That's going to help his SEO. It's going to help him drive more traffic. And that's all because he did a guest blog for us. So you might be wondering which WordPress plugins can improve your local SEO ranking. I would love to dive in deeper to this and talk about what you can do within your own website to boost your local SEO using WordPress plugins. Now, here's some recommended options, starting with Yoast SEO or Yoast Local SEO. You've heard me talk about this in other videos on The Journey. And this plugin is designed specifically to help your sites rank better in local search. And this is actually one of the most popular WordPress plugins. And you can install it for free. Yes, you heard me correctly. Free. And the plugin will help you optimize specifically for your location, including Google Maps and Google My Business.
Yeah, Yoast has been just crucial when I go and help my clients set up their local SEO or just SEO in general. It gives you all the great recommendations and really helps you improve over time to get those better results on those search engine pages. The next plugin we have here is the Business Profile plugin. This enhances your opportunity to earn citations from Google by making it incredibly easy to include business name, address, phone number, contact info, opening hours, and even a link to your Google Maps.
Another recommended option is a Schema plugin, and adding metadata known as Schema Markup delivers the most important granular detail that search engines require. Now, for local SEO, Schema Markup tells search engines where the website's business is actually located, and the Schema plugin simplifies the task of adding schema markups to WordPress.
Next up, we have Google Places Reviews. So Google Places Reviews helps you display your business reviews and ratings directly on your website. Again, people trust online reviews and search engine factor in a website's review profile for SEO. So the more you can include reviews on your website, the better.
I second that. Another option, local SEO and business listings. Now, with this plugin, a local SEO guide helps you create and update your business listings across more than 50 business listing sources, including Bing Places, Yellow Pages, Yelp, and more.
And lastly, we have WP Google Maps. So most people will use Google to find local businesses. So getting your local business's map embedded on your website and rankings on the Google Maps listings is a must-do. You can make the entire process easier just with this plugin.
And when people search for a business, they're typically looking for a local provider. So optimizing your WordPress sites for local SEO, it's pretty obvious, right? It's going to help you rise above your competition. So it'll pay off to pay attention to site design best practices, leverage the power of WordPress plugins, and focus on local SEO ranking factors.
All right, those are our WordPress plugins to help you with your local SEO, but your journey does not have to end here. We have over 200 videos to help you out with your entrepreneurial game.
That's right, and be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Thanks for watching. This is The Journey.